Today on the BV3D channel, I'll show you an easy way to clear broken filament from the AMS light on the Bamboo Lab A1 or A1 Mini. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. More on them in just a bit. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Okay, so today I want to show you an easy way to clear broken filament from the PTFE tubes on the Bamboo Lab A1 or A1 Mini with an AMS light. It doesn't require a specially designed tool, but good news, I designed one anyway, and you can download and print it for free. There's a link for it in the description. First of all, while I love my Bamboo Lab printers, the AMS light can make your life miserable if you suffer a filament break inside one of the PTFE tubes that connect it to your A1 or A1 Mini. When filament breaks in those tubes, it can be a pain in the rear to get them cleared. While it's easy to remove the PTFE tubes from the AMS light side, it's almost impossible to remove them from that 4-into-1 filament thing on the tool head. The official name of that part is the AMS light filament hub. For each of the 4 PTFE tubes feeding into it, there's a retaining ring that can be pressed down to release that tube, in theory. And I previously designed a tool to make that a little bit easier to do. But those retaining rings can be exceptionally stubborn and don't always want to let go of the tubing. So I'll show you another way, and we'll get to that in about 30 seconds. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo, these are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. It's important to know what we're dealing with, so let's talk for a minute about the A1 and A1 Mini tool head. The AMS light filament hub is mounted on top of it and it's spring-loaded. If the filament somehow gets tangled or snagged on the AMS light side and the extruder keeps pulling on the filament, that tension starts to compress the spring and the entire filament hub starts getting pulled down toward the tool head. This triggers a sensor in the tool head, which is how the printer is able to detect filament jams at the AMS light. Anyway, there's a retainer snapped on right here, which keeps the spring from just launching the filament hub off the top of the tool head. So the secret to getting the AMS light filament hub off the tool head is unsnapping that retainer. You could use a flathead screwdriver to get underneath it and pry it up, and that works, but that could gouge or damage the plastic. And you don't want to gouge or damage the plastic, do you? No. No, you don't. Of course not. Why would you even ask something like that? That's barbaric. So I designed a tool you can print to help separate the AMS light filament hub from the tool head. Since it's plastic, it's much less likely to accidentally leave a mark on your printer. This is similar to a tool commonly called a spudger, often used in electronics repair. There's a flat prying surface and a pointy poking surface, and typically this is used to unlock and disconnect cables on motherboards and stuff like that. For this application, we're going to use the flat side to pop up the right side of the filament hub's retaining collar. Remember, this is a spring-loaded affair. Hold on to the filament hub so it and the spring don't go flying. And then use the flat prying side to do some prying. There's a little notch where you can fit the corner of the tool to do this. 90% of the time, the left side of the retaining collar stays snapped in place, but the tool can take care of that too. Use the ramp-like side of the tool to slide into the seam between the tool head and the collar. That will pop it loose without much of a fight. Now that the collar is free, you can lift the filament hub straight up and off the tool head. With the filament hub removed from the tool head, you can remove the filament that broke off inside the tube by disconnecting that particular tube from the AMS light, and then use even more filament to push the broken piece out. And if there's still some filament stuck in the tool head, you can press the cutting lever and just pull that filament up and out. Then reconnect any tubes back to the AMS light and snap the filament hub back onto the tool head. There's one piece of that retaining collar that sticks down a little further than the rest of it, and that's the part you pried up on. It fits in that notch, so use that to make sure the collar is aligned correctly. Then, after making sure the nozzle is at room temperature, support the tool head from below and press the whole filament hub down until the collar snaps back into place. I tested this procedure on 3 different printers and it worked fine on all 3. That said, there may be differences between my printers and yours, so your mileage may vary. I deliberately kept this video super short, and I made a tool you can download for free from the link in the description. So before you go, if you found this video helpful, do me a favor and subscribe. That lets me know I'm making content that you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we've got for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.